This is to you, Deep and Debraj, very common sort of this thing. So TK's writer on YouTube asks, Sultana's Dream is a fascinating instance of utopian writing in the feminist vein with detailed world building. Did this initiate a genre of utopian writing, if not SF in Bangla, or was it a one-off? And then Tarun asks on chat, who are the contemporary women authors writing SF in Bengal? Is there any lineage of utopian writing that can be traced to Rokeya Hossain?
Not really. We actually in Kalpavishya we published an issue on only Bengali women writers. Bengali women writers write science fiction, and we actually named it Konkavati Kalpobigyan Lekheni. Konkavati didn't write Kalpobigyan. We named it. Okay. Konkavati was actually backstory. That was a fantasy character by Trailokyanath. It was very famous fantasy character in Bengali, Konkavati. So we named it for Konkavati Kalpobigyan Lekheni. And all of that issue, it was almost 30, we have published 30 stories, science fiction and fantasy stories by Bengali authors, and all of them are women. And what I find that almost maybe 60 or 70% stories were actually not utopian, dystopian stories.
Oh my God.
And yeah, those stories.
They are seeing the reality, actually, basically.
Yeah.
They are seeing the reality.
So people are like much different in that thinking pattern than Sekhar Sultana's Dream's time. Things have changed. So on those stories, mainly that
during Sultana's Dream,
like women are there feeling that they're helpless. That feeling actually came out very, very prominently, that how helpless they are in our society.
Which month or which year issue was this? Because there's someone called Anushree says, her research through zero names of Bangla women contemporary writers.
Actually, there are not much contemporary writers who write science fiction or fantasy regularly. But you can look for Jashodhara Rai Choudhury. Jashodhara Rai Choudhury is actually daughter of Dr. Dilip Rai Choudhury, that original writer. Yeah. Yeah. Of Ashajaya era. And there is Lila Mujundar. Lila Mujundar is also aunt of...
Related to, Satyajit Ray.
Yeah. She wrote wonderful science fictions. And there are some science fiction written by Bani Basu. There is a science fiction I can...
Bani Basu, I guess, Matatua. Is the mother of Samit Basu, I guess. Yeah. Am I correct?
Yeah.
I'm not sure.
I guess.
And then in English, okay. I know for sure that Sukanya Datta writes a lot of science fiction.
Yeah, wrote lots of science fiction, yes.
But Samit Basu, she writes in English.
Mm-hmm. And
then Rini Chatterjee is also there.
She also wrote in English, yeah.
So there are two. Bengalis who are writing in English.
Yeah, there's another question from YouTube by Ishwar. He asks, out of curiosity, Buddhist canon speaks of other worlds populated by sentient beings. I was wondering if the inspiration for Bengali science fiction came from the long Buddhist rule by the Pala dynasty.
That's an interesting question.
It is. It's a very interesting question.
I'm not sure because there are lots of... science fiction where some otherworldly people or other worlds came in our world. Those are actually mostly coming from translation from English or different literatures, like is
European literature.
European literature, yeah. I mean, those kind of stories were heavily influenced from Western literature. So I'm not sure whether it's coming from Buddhist literature.
It's an interesting question. Something to think about.
Yeah.
So Hashfire has written Ray Dynasty. This guy is great.
Okay. No, obviously, it's a Ray Dynasty. I mean, and I wish we could spend more time on the whole Ray alien story, but we put that in, which is, when people, Debraj, you mentioned Koi Mil Gaya, and when when people say that, it's a ripoff of Spielberg's E.T.,
And E.T. is from
Rakesh Roshan just ripping. Yeah. I say, no. This is Rakesh Roshan taking revenge, on behalf of India for ripping off Satyajit Ray.
I don't know how. That's really magical words you have said, man. Really jaduish. Love it.
Come on. Okay. Pandit ji.
I think there was another comment somewhere in between about Adrish Vardhan being investigated for his nom de plume.
Yeah. Did
that actually happen?
Pardon?
I've heard about this.
There was a comment in between about Adrish Vardhan being investigated for his pen name, basically. Did that happen or is this just an urban legend?
Investigated for?
His pen name.
Oh, yeah. That actually happened. He was, at the beginning, he was actually using a pen name to as an editor of Ascharya. He was using some pen name as Akash Sen. That's because that time they didn't have much writer to write science fiction in that magazine. So he used Akash Sen as an editor name and he used to write stories as Adrish Vardhan. What happened that he was called in Lal Bazar and the police officer actually told him that who is Akash Sen, and he said, I am the Akash Sen. So he said that you can't do it. So, and after that, he said that I read also science fiction. This is a very good magazine you are going, you are doing. So keep doing it, but do it on your own name. Don't do it.
You could have written about the politics of that particular era.
Deep, Tarun is asking, what is the issue and month of the special issue on women authors, the Kalpabiswa issue that you're talking about?
Just give me a second. I'll share the link.
Yeah, sure. Thank you.
He's ready.
Yeah. I mean, speaking of Akash Sen, I mean, fascinating story, but I would love to hear the author-editor conversation between Akash Sen, the editor, and Adrish Vardhan, the writer. Absolutely fabulous to watch.